Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for August to October 2019. Drier and warmer than average conditions are likely to continue at least into October. And fire potential this season is higher than usual for parts of southern Queensland. But first, let's look at recent conditions. The first half of the year was very dry. This has extended the drought in many areas. But July saw timely rains in parts of Western Australia and the southeast. Western Tasmania, in particular, had above average rainfall for the month. Mid-July also brought strong winds and snow to southeastern Australia. However, temperatures for our coolest month of the year remained above average in most areas. Nights in inland Western Australia and across the top end were colder than usual. Southern Australia was warmer overall, but some nights still brought winter, fog and frost. With warm and mostly dry conditions continuing in the east and southwest, soil moisture remains below average for many key agricultural regions. Midwinter is the time of year when we'd normally see southern water storages filling. But there's been little change in overall storage levels in the southeastern mainland over the past month. Levels in the northern Murray-Darling Basin are still at just 7%. So what will influence our climate over the next few months? El Niño now looks unlikely to form in the Pacific Ocean this year. The Indian Ocean is the dominant influence on the outlook, with climate models favouring a positive Indian Ocean dipole. This is typically associated with drier conditions over central and southern Australia during winter and spring, and an early start to the southern bushfire season. Another shorter-term climate driver has also been affecting us in July. A northward shift of cold fronts, called a negative southern annular mode, or SAM, brought the wild weather and rains to southeastern Australia. However, this negative SAM period is now coming to an end. So what does all that mean for our August to October outlook? Average to drier than average conditions are likely for much of Australia, largely due to the influence of the positive Indian Ocean dipole. Streamflow forecasts for July to September suggest low flows are likely to continue for nearly two-thirds of locations across Australia. Near median and high flows are more likely in regions such as northeastern Queensland that had above average rainfall earlier in the year. Turning to temperatures for August to October, days are very likely to be warmer than average for most of Australia. Clear nights and dry soils in southern inland areas will raise the risk of frost. It's now fire season in the north. Parts of southern Queensland have higher than usual fire potential. This is the result of vegetation that has dried out since the start of the year. For the remainder of northern Australia, fire potential is likely to be normal for the season. For more details, visit the Bushfire and Natural Hazards CRC website. We've already seen bushfires in southeastern New South Wales due to dry conditions, so take care with those winter burn-offs, particularly on windy days. In summary, for much of the country, we're expecting an average to drier than average August to October. Temperatures are likely to be warmer than average. Low stream flows are likely at most locations. And there's an increased risk of bushfires in parts of southern Queensland. For more details, visit bomb.gov.au/climate/ahead. Our first look at likely conditions for spring will be available on Thursday, the 15th of August.